is a hard game, don't you blame. It's your chance to rise your aim. Let your spirit be brave, always fight to hold your name. No matter how bad or rough, you never surrender.
The storyline is really very simple. This is about a guy who's new in Rome. He doesn't speak English, nor does he understand it. He wants to eat, but orders the wrong food. He wants to bathe, but he doesn't know how to use the bathroom. He doesn't believe in banks. He thinks that if he deposits the money he's worked hard for, he won't get it back.
He's a really funny but weird guy.
Right. But this man will become a hero. With a twist towards the end, in the name of justice, he faces bad guys and beats them. Besides that, this man, though very simple and knows little about many things, will show us what dignity really is and that everyone must have it. We follow the usual pattern of films, where woman is saved by man, or hero saves beauty kind of thing. Although, the main character of this story, our weird guy, Tang Long, isn't a regular guy. He's shy in front of women. He doesn't know how to deal with them at all. Reason is, he happens to be dumb. Chisha man, what do you think?
It's fine, but I'll add something. This guy, Tang Long, is naive. He doesn't even know that I'm in love with him. I take him to Rome to see some romantic places, but he doesn't get it. He's way too insensitive.
Right. I think that's enough. Right now, we need to save up. What I mean is, inside shots will be taken, just in Hong Kong. That way, we won't run out of money unnecessarily. So, the scenes we'll be shooting here in Italy will all be outdoor. Now for the staff, I've already booked all of you in a nearby hotel.
You're already the big boss now. Why are you so stingy?
Hey, when I get rich someday, I'm telling you, I'll take you out. But we're from Hong Kong, not Hollywood. We have to spend on what's important. You got that? Everything clear?
Yes, sir. All right, good. Come on. Everybody to their places now.
Let's hurry.
Put all the stuff where they should be. Okay.
Let's start the scene from here. Right there. Why'd you get us this cheap motel? It looks sleazy.
Hey, Bruce. Do you know how much funds we have? This should be enough for now.
This is bad. Find a hotel. Just cheap, but good. It's not right for the staff.
Bruce, that's okay. This is why you also live in this motel.
He's right. We came here to shoot, not to indulge.
Shaman.
Wherever you go, I'll follow.
All right.
Let's go.
Action!
Look, it's so nice. Look at that garden. You know what? An emperor built it for his empress. It took many years just to finally complete it. Did you like the palace?
It's just way too big. What a waste.
Cut! Great! Good, good, good! Nice!
That was great.
It's amazing. Wow, all right. Go and change the set. Do it now. Faster, faster. Come on, come on.
Thank you. Shaman, you did so well.
You should tell yourself that. The script's actually very nice. Plus, your acting's really cute. Did you know that?
Really,
Shaman? Why would I lie? Honestly, I'm liking you again.
Shaman.
I mean, your character.
Shaman, actually, I really want to say thanks.
For what? Why do you have to say that?
Because you left smiling-faced Tiger for me immediately and flew with me to Rome.
That's because I didn't really like the role I played in that movie. This means I should be the one to say thanks because you took me out of that film.
All right. That means we're even now. We don't owe each other. Thanks.
Actually, I really thought that you could only play roles like Chen Zhen, your character in Fist of Fury. I was wrong. You can even play Tang Long, which is amazing.
Actually, there's only two kinds of actors. First, there's an actor who's versatile, just like you are. And the other actor is a type that doesn't know how to portray different roles. As for me, I'm the kind of type in between. Back then, I played hero roles, which was usual. But in any role I play, I always put a part of myself.
I think you're right. But in the way you're acting, Tang Long seems too indifferent to his partner. Aren't you being natural?
Not exactly. I mean, look, Tang Long's a genius when it comes to combat. But since he's a naive young man who comes from a far-off countryside, when it comes to love affairs, he doesn't really know much.
You're exactly that.
You think so? Tell everyone that by 6 in the morning, we'll start. The weather's not getting any better. We should film as much as we can. Okay, let's start rehearsing. All right. Let's try the first one.
Okay.
And next. Then at the back. Then another. One more. Did you get it?
Yeah.
Remember, guys, follow your positions. Go practice together. Okay, come on. Let's begin. Come on. Good. Everyone ready? I am. Let's start. Ready when you are. Remember, practice, all right? Clapper! Scene 22, take one! Action! Bruce, what's happening?
Are you okay?
What happened? Bruce! Call the ambulance!
Bruce! It's Bruce! What's wrong? Are you hurt? What? What's wrong, Bruce? Tell us!
What's wrong? Something's wrong with Bruce!
I'm fine. Just go over to the scene. Don't waste any time.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
All right, get him up.
Come on.
Easy.
I'm okay. Let's get going.
Sure that?
Yes, I am.
You heard him? Go!
Be careful, okay?
Yeah.
Go back to your places! Let's begin. Come on! Okay, ready? Everyone ready?
Yeah.
Stand by. Clapper.
Scene 22, take two.
Action.
Inside?
He's sleeping. I'll get him.
Just let him. He needs rest.
I'm not sleeping. I'm thinking of how the Colosseum scene will be executed. This scene has to be extraordinary. I asked someone over. My friend Hoffman. We'll go to Rome together and finish shooting the movie. All right?
Many fights since you invited me here.
I know. But to save money, we rehearse here. I also have a crew in Hong Kong. That lowers my expenses a lot, because it's cheap there. But in Rome, it's expensive.
I didn't know you make films this way.
Listen, down to business. For this scene, the lead's heroic side should come out.
You still practice Jeet Kune Do?
That's right. We'll do a balanced fight. I think it should last for about 10 minutes to properly show my kung fu.
Excuse me, Mr. Lee.
Let's wait a minute.
How did your filming in Rome go?
It was good.
Of course, we had a few problems.
Diva was here to shoot this new movie. Will Save the Dragon be better than the others?
Of course. I could attempt to make it a classic kung fu movie.
Well then, can you tell us how much you predict the film will gross?
To be honest, I think $5 million won't even be a problem.
Why don't you go watch your film?
To be honest, I don't feel like watching my movie now.
But why?
I'm afraid that the result wouldn't be as good as I said it would. If that happens, what'll I do?
I already knew that's what you had in mind. You didn't even have to tell me.
Really now?
I know you already. Most of the time you're strong, but there are times when you're weak.
I like the funny scenes. They're quite effective. They make the film even more entertaining. It's something Hong Kong hasn't seen before. I think that Bruce has done it again.
Just watch. There's more.
Linda, to tell you the truth, just last night, I was feeling really confident. But today, I don't know. I don't know what the outcome will be. I'm not even sure. Now that the film's being shown not just in Hong Kong, I don't know what to expect. I want to give up.
Don't worry. You'll make it. Just trust me.
These newspapers from all over Asia, all these papers show Bruce Lee's success. Those are written in different languages, in Chinese, English, Thai. He's just popular everywhere. And those are not everything. The whole Southeast Asia is going crazy after Bruce Lee. That's incredible. What's even more incredible is that the Hong Kong box office grossed a total of 5 million Hong Kong dollars.
5 million Hong Kong dollars? Is that true?
That's right. And in the succeeding weeks, I'm very sure it will still go up more.
Wow. He's amazing. I can't believe he achieved this. I didn't think he had the ability to make a movie gross this much. I never imagined it would earn this much money.
It's definitely amazing. Many of our movies from Hollywood can't make that much profit in Asia.
That's true. Honestly, I think we really made a big mistake.
Don't worry, I'll get that fixed. I'll fly to Hong Kong right now and talk to them as soon as I get there.
Tell me, what do you plan to do?
Oh, William, here it is. I'll show him this. This is what I plan to show him.
Good. Blood and Steel sounds interesting.
Mr. Lee, I heard that when you came back with your crew from Rome, you told the press at the airport that your first self-produced written and directed film will earn $5 million. Now that what you said has come true, how are you feeling?
Actually, I'm not very sure how I'm going to say this. Well, I believe in myself. I have faith in my abilities. I want my films to be a kind of breakthrough in the film industry. That's my goal. I want to give my fans a special brand of films made by Bruce Lee and satisfy them. You know, when I finished writing Way of the Dragon, I already felt confident. When we were shooting the movie in Rome, especially when my student Hoffman came in and joined us, my confidence grew even more. I know exactly now what my fans, my audience, really want to watch, and I'll give them that. I believe that this is the key to my success.
Excuse me, Mr. Lee. Your leading lady in the movie, Miss Qin Shao Ma, also did very well. Do you have any words for her?
To be honest with you, I love Qin Shao Ma. I really think that she's very good. So fans accepted her well. I do admire her a lot.
Mr. Lee, how about we hear Miss Qin Shao Ma talk about you in your first writing, directing, and acting job? If I may ask, was he great at all of them? Bruce Lee's like a son, and I'm just the moon that revolves around him. If you're asking if he's good, I would say he's more than that. Words really won't suffice to describe Bruce Lee. See that? Bruce!
Oh.
Bruce! Bruce?
Looks like the master's busy.
Bruce! George's here.
Oh, I think he doesn't want to see me.
Hey, George.
Oh, how are you? For
Fine.
A moment, I thought he didn't want to see
Sid.
Me.
Why wouldn't I? You're a friend of mine. Of course I want to see you. Come on, sit down.
Oh, know what? The reason I went here is because Hollywood wants you to be its next
really?
Big star.
George, just go back to Hollywood.
Yeah, you're straightforward. Forget about that. Treat this as a private visit from an old friend. That way you won't force me out of your house.
How about some kung fu tea, then? Hmm? Please?
Okay.
Kung fu tea? Why not? I'm just a little thirsty right now.
That's good.
Back then I saw a Japanese tea ceremony on TV. This time I'd like to experience the real Japanese tea ceremony for myself. I think that'll be great. It's Japanese tea ceremony you'll show me, right?
You're completely mistaken, George. This is the real thing. The Japanese one gets only the superficial part of the Chinese tea ceremony.
Oh. Oh, you always make me feel really embarrassed with all the things you know.
You don't know the Chinese very well. Linda, please check on the kids. Go now.
Oh, sure. Bye, George.
Oh, Linda's really nice. You know what? I'm clueless about Kung Fu Tea.
Oh.
But you know what I know? Your career. It's now reached this peak. You've become number one.
That's thanks to Hollywood. They pushed me back to Hong Kong, and it helped me.
Don't mention that anymore. William himself asked me to give you a visit. That's why I came here. He really wants to make up for what he's done to you.
George, I want you to tell William for me. His big mistake is only just beginning. I'll make sure William will regret refusing Bruce Lee his career opportunity.
Well, I understand. But you should forget about that. Enough of that, Bruce. I don't want to beat around the bush with you. I went to Hong Kong not just to visit you, all right? I came here because I have a proposal for you. Do you want to listen to it?
What is it? What's your proposal?
Okay, I'll tell you. Do you still remember Robert?
Oh, of course. Of course, Robert. He's the most talented scriptwriter I've ever known in my life.
Oh, So you still regard him that way? I guess we can easily go then. This is his new script, which he wrote especially for you. He really wanted you to have it.
New script? Familiar. Blood and Steel. Correct me if I'm wrong, but is this another silent flute?
Oh, forget it, Bruce. I've told you not to bear those bad things in mind. Get over them. Please look forward.
What's waiting ahead of us, then?
Oh, we're friends. I can tell you, this is a big Hollywood movie. This means Hollywood has accepted your kung fu films. You've become a real star now. Just read it carefully, and you'll see there. Listen, I'm telling you, this will make you famous in Hollywood.
It's all right. But right now I'm preparing for my movie Game of Death, so I'm afraid I can't attend to this.
Oh, I understand that. But if you'll ask me, I'd rather choose Hollywood. Hong Kong can't give what Hollywood can. I believe you already know which is much more important between the options you have at the moment. We'll pay you your basic standard. You'll be the highest paid Chinese star. Isn't this what you wanted to happen before? This is exactly your dream.
Okay, okay. I think I'll need more time to think about it.
Bruce, just tell me, what is it?
To be honest, I can hardly decide. That's why I want to ask you about it.
Bruce, you're someone who values loyalty. Are you just asking me about this because you're morally obliged? Thank you, but this isn't needed. I've told you before, you're free. If you want to go, then just go ahead.
Boss, when I lived in the US before, I made three simple wishes. First, to promote my own martial art, Jeet Kune Do, to introduce Kung Fu to those who don't know it. Second, to make Chinese films known in the world market, so people across the globe will be familiar with our movies. Third, I want to play a lead role in a Hollywood film so that Chinese actors will all be respected. Well, my two wishes have been fulfilled now. The third one, for that, this film is a chance for me to fulfill that last wish.
Bruce, I totally understand how you feel. Why not postpone Game of Death? Go to Hollywood and do what you want to do.
Mr. Chow, thank you so much. You've convinced me to do what I should.
Bruce, when you work there, how will you be recognized? How will Hollywood treat you?
As a lead actor, I guess.
Do you want to hear my advice on that?
Why not? That's why I came here.
Bruce, you're not just a kung fu star who's influential when it comes to the box office. You're also a partner of this company.
Why do you mention that?
Hollywood can give you a lot. Why don't you partner with a company there and represent Golden Harvest?
Partner with a company and represent Golden Harvest. Right. That way, I won't sign just as an actor working for them. I can also be a partner.
Which means you will share profit with that company.
That's right. I should have thought of that. That way, I can fulfill my wish and star in a Hollywood film and still stay with Golden Harvest. More importantly, Bruce Lee will enter Hollywood as their equal.
Much better, right? Come on, Bruce. Let's celebrate.
You're amazing! You're a good friend!
No, no, no. It's just impossible.
Why?
Well, because that doesn't exist in Hollywood. I've never heard of that kind of partnership.
Why can't I do it? You hired a Chinese for your film. So what's the problem then?
Bruce, you've already got tons of money right in your hands. You shouldn't be greedy. That's not right. Yeah, so much money, isn't that enough for you? Don't ask for too much.
George, it seems there's no point in going on with this discussion.
Bruce, I better make it clear to you. I'm representing William now. William is highly regarded in Hollywood. He's not just a nobody there, you know? You want to be on equal footing with him? That's just crazy. That's impossible.
I don't care who William is or what those Hollywood rules are for. Right now, I am representing Golden Harvest, and I want to co-produce this film with your company, okay? If you don't agree with what I'm saying, just say this never happened.
Okay. This is a big problem. I'll ask for instructions. See ya.
Why are you changing the film's title?
Because they need to use this title. That's one of my conditions. They should give in to everything I say. That's what I'm worth now.
I think you're asking far too much.
No, Linda. These things I'm asking for are small.
But George is the one representing Hollywood, right?
Hollywood, so what? Back then, when I was in Hollywood, I was nothing. It's different now. I'm a star. Even Hollywood can no longer look down on me.
What if they don't accept it?
They'll accept it. I mean, the role in the script is mine. No one else can play it.
Yes, William, it's me. It's me, right. Okay, I got it. Okay, I certainly understand. Okay, I'll follow you. But if... Wait a minute, William. If we want to get him in the movie, this is the only way. We have to give in to his demands, and we have to deal with it. I'm glad you see it my way. Whoa. Ooh. Right.
Bruce, who could this be?
No, I'll take it.
Hello, Bruce?
Hey, George. George, his answer's no, right? Did he get mad? He couldn't accept my terms?
Wait, Bruce. He's a nice guy. He can't give you anything. You just have to wait.
It's the first time I've heard you say something good about William. So what? Did it help solve your problem or not?
He definitely did. He accepted all the conditions you gave him.
That's good. Actually, I'm not that surprised. Because Americans always make sure they get what they want. Personal issues are nothing. Your boss knows what our partnership will give us. It's something that we both want. It's profit, right?
At least that's all cleared up now. We'll discuss the details of the contract tomorrow.
Okay. As for the details, Mr. Raymond Chow of Golden Harvest will talk to you about that.
Hey, George.
No bad blood between us, right? Let me tell you something that comes from my heart. Now I can be at ease because I know Hollywood won't discriminate against me.
You're such a smart guy. You can do anything you want.
Hey, hold on.
I have one more condition.
Oh, one more? What now?
The film's title must be changed. I've thought of one. The original title, Blood and Steel, it's lame.
Then what?
Enter the Dragon.
Oh, so that's what you want. I don't understand. What's the difference between the titles?
Nice, right? Sounds powerful.
You're really a stubborn man. Okay, yeah. No problem. We can still accept that.
Bye. Linda. We did it!
Action!
We shall love, a little so bad.
amazing, Bruce. Bruce.
You were great.
Very good.
Everyone, well done. Yeah. Good job.
Yeah. Did you like what it? You did, which is amazing.
Really happens. That's how.
Thanks, everyone.
Why don't you rest over there?
Did it give you a scare, darling?
Yes. You shouldn't scare me like that again.
Bruce, listen, you look good. Hey, George, did we finish shooting the movie?
It was great. You really impressed me.
So tell me, are you satisfied?
No one can do it better. You're a genius.
Finally, I fulfilled my last dream.
You look very weak. Rest some more, okay?
Let's leave him alone. Let Bruce take a good rest now. Come on now, Linda.
Sleep well, Bruce.
Come on. Before.
He complains about his headaches, but this hasn't happened before.
He's too hardworking. You know, you should take him back to America immediately.
I know. But Bruce said he had to finish shooting the film. But I think now we can go back.
Yeah, Bruce always works hard for his kung fu to keep improving. He doesn't seem to want to stop or even rest.
He's
right?
Always like that.
He should rest now.
Linda, I rushed here when I heard about him. Oh, how is he?
Mr.
Is he okay?
Chao, he's already away.
Good.
You can go in and have
right.
a look. Okay.
I have to go.
Bye. See you.
Bruce, how are you?
I'm fine. I just experienced the feeling of death. It was like my Game of Death movie.
What are you talking about? You're just 32, okay? Don't you talk about death.
I'm not sick. I'm all right. Let's go home. Hey, when we finish Enter the Dragon, let's continue filming the Game of Death.
You're still sick. You should rest for a while, Bruce. Wait for what the doctors would say. Besides, this isn't the right time to think about your pending work. Right now, focus on your recovery. You understand?
I just said I'm fine. I'm all right.
Linda, I'll go find the hospital's director. I'll ask for the best doctor here and for the best equipment so they can give Bruce here a complete checkup.
Okay,
I don't need that.
You need that. You will get the checkup. Excuse me.
Bruce, you should know how to take care of yourself. Understand? Mm-hmm. have an apple?
I don't want to.
So you're feeling better now?
Mm-hmm.
Bruce, just have a good rest. I'll go back and look after the kids.
All right. Don't tell Mom. Don't tell anyone about this. This is between you and me. Promise?
I promise. Bye. I'll see you.
Thank you.